Hello gamers, today I'm going to play Forbidden Stars. Forbidden Stars is a galactic warfare game, and today I'm going to have a match between Space Marines and Orcs. So I already set up the map for the two factions. I'm not going to go step by step how you build the map. There are many other videos in YouTube that you can see how to build the map. So the map, I preset the map for this skirmish. And let's jump just straight to the action. Our Space Marine starts with 4 scouts, 1 Space Marine, 1 Strike Cruiser, 1 Factory and 6 material. So we have the 6 material here, and we can see our army distributed to the related planets. And let's have the background story about the Marines. Commander, we have received an astronomic relay from the Expeditionary fleet of Ulysses Ithanos, who has uncovered a safe warp passage to the Heraklon cluster. The warp storms that surround that lost region have abated, and the worlds once thought consumed are intact and inhabited. Our strike cruisers are en route to Captain Ulysses' passage. Orders have been disseminated through the company. The inhabited systems are to be secured for Imperial compliance. All traitor or Xenos threats are to be purged and the loyal worlds made safe. Any rebellious worlds must be brought to heel. For the Emperor, Giltman and Macragge. Brother Sergeant Corellius, Ultramarines Veteran Sergeant. And for our enemy, which will be the Orcs, starts with 4 Orc boys, 1 Nob, 1 Factory, 1 Reinforcement Token and 6 Material. The background story for the Orcs. The beasts are coming. The Great Green Horde, swarming within their twisted hulls, has erupted from the warp to descend upon us. Nowhere in the Heraklon cluster is safe. Their crewed ships shall soon be upon any worlds. The Orc cannot be reasoned with. They cannot be turned aside with diplomacy or negotiations. They cannot even be bought. They ravage our worlds for what I can only describe as a single joy of the fight. How can one stand against such a tide of distraction? What can we do against the screen skins? If we do not receive aid, we will certainly fail. Fall, crushed beneath the horde unending. Castor Thrax, planetary government of Medrias. So after the beat of the background story, we are ready to go. Okay, before we start, let's see what this board shows to us. First of all, it shows the specific skill that each race has. So, Space Marines, when we use a Dominate order, you may spend one material to replace one Scout with one free Space Marine, or replace one free Space Marine with one free Land Raider. The Space Marine starts with 6 materia. And this diagram here shows the command level that we start at the beginning. And as we build cities, it increases, and the more higher it is on the level, the better units you can build. The green symbol here shows it represents the material, which is the money. So in order to build a city, you need 3 materia, and in order to build a factory, you need 2 materia, and in order to build a bastion, you need 2 materia. Each building gives different skills. The city, when you build the cities, you upgrade your command level, so you will be able later on to build better units. The factory, just you build units on the map, so there that I have my factory. In this planet I can build units according to the current command level that I have. So my command level here is 0, I will be able over the map to build scouts or strike cruisers. And the bastion, it is a unit that helps in battle, and it gives for each battle 2 dice. It has 3 life, and at the end of the game, if both players have a unit still alive, you count down the morale, and whoever has the largest amount of morale wins the battles. And the same applies for all other units. Each race also starts with orders that he can play during his turn. He has 4 different orders. The first order will be deploy, which actually you build units on the map by playing this order. The second order that you can play is strategize. Strategize help you upgrade your combat deck. Dominate, it provides resources when you play that, depending on what kind of resource each plant can give. And finally, advance allows you to move units from one system to another, or start a battle, or start an orbital strike. We will see them through our gameplay. Each race also starts with 10 combat card deck, where they will use this to the battle. We will show how the mechanisms work during our playthrough. And has to have to his area the event deck, which is over there. And when you play a dominate, not a dominate, when you play a strategize order, you just play your token on this, and then when you draw the card, it shows you what kind of scheme or tactic you have drawn, and you do certain actions after. And here we can see also our upgrade deck for our combat deck, where you can just simply upgrade your units to better armory and skills during your combat. Okay, for the first action, orcs play first, so they will pick up one order token and they are going to place it on their home world. Second, marine plays, and marines, they will do a build action for their home world. Then orc plays and put his second order to the map. Then marines play and they plan to do they will play a dominate order to this system. Then orc will play their action and they will use this order. Marines, they are going to play a strategize order and place it to this system. And finally, orc, they are planning to do another order. Marines play their last order on this system and let the game begin. We start with orcs. Orcs reveal this order first. It's a dominate order. Dominate order allows the orcs, when you resolve a dominate order, you may purchase one unit and place it on a friendly war on the active system. So they will do that. They will spend one materia and they will place one orc boy to this system. And then space marines play, and space marines, they will choose to move their forces to this system from one adjacent system. So this goes over here. This goes over here, this goes over here. And this is for the Space Marines. Then Orc will play another order. Strategize, so Orc, they decide to play the strategize order, and they are going to look their deck and pick up one new unit. They decide to buy the Biker Boys, which is command level 0, and it requires 2 materia. So they go for 3, and they drop one unit from their deck. And they are planning to drop Gretchens. Okay, they replaced Gretchens with the Biker Boys, and they place also the strategy token to their event deck that will be activated by the end of the round. Next, Marines, they play the build order over there. They will spend 2 materia to build up a scout, so the 6 goes to 4. And they will place the scout over there, and they will spend another 2 resources to To build a strike cruiser. And this is the end for the build order for the Space Marines. Then Orc play and they play the build order for this system, and they will build a Bastion. So they built up the Bastion with their command order, and they do nothing else. Space Marines, they reveal their order, it is Dominate, and they gain one Forge token. They spent, they played the Dominate order, they spent one materia to upgrade one Scout to a Space Marine. Finally, Orc play their command order, and they make a build to this system. Two materia, and they build another Orc boy. And this is the end for the Orcs. And last command, it is last order. The Space Marines, they play the strategy deck, and they are going to upgrade one of their units. As you see, Space Marines, they decide to replace the reconnaissance with veteran scouts. This ends their action for playing the strategic order. We also place the strategic order to the event step, and we are ready to move on to the refresh phase. First, we collect objectives. There's no objective to collect. Then we collect materia from all our planets. So let's see what Orcs get. Orcs will get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 materia. So they have 1 plus 5, they go back to 6. And Space Marines, they have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 materia. They already have 1, so they go back to 6 again also. Next step is the rally step. Then it is move the warp storms and resolve events. So Orcs, they play, because they have the played the strategic order, they get how we get there. This, because it's a tactic act, it takes effect immediately. Take one of your units from any world and place it to any other uncontrolled world. They take this Orc boy and they move it over here because of the tactic. Then they have to move the warp to the direction that they want. So it is like that. And they decide to move this warp over there. Space Marines, they play their event. It's a scheme for them. Place this card in your play area and discard all other schemes. At the start of the Naxxus damage step of the combat, you may discard this card to gain 2 defenses and 1 additional defense token for each force token you have. So it's a defensive card that goes to our play. This is the end of the event phase, and also we have to move this warp over there. This is the end of the warp step, and this is the end of a round, and we jump to 10-2.